there was two versions of the film. I saw it at Toronto, and then I saw the shorter version. And I see the merits of both cuts. Like, I like the longer cut because you get to spend so much more time with these characters, but I also understand that, like, modern audiences, a lot of people like a shorter movie, that, you know, like a 2-hour cut's better for them. Can you sort of talk about why you made it, like, you did the second cut? I guess we'll start with that.
Well, yeah, I played the film in Toronto, and you really responded to it. But I had a sense from the screening that we were maybe running a bit long. We'd rushed the film to get into TIFF anyway, so there was a sense that there was some work that was still undone. So I took the opportunity to go back into the film and do some editing, and somehow or other felt that shortening was the right thing to do. And took out one or two sequences and then trimmed some other things and tried to kind of work on a slightly smoother arc into it, you know, maybe more graceful arc into the journey of the film, and this weird less is more approach that I think bore fruit. And I would definitely say I infinitely prefer the shorter version, but you know, you've seen both of them. What we had to sacrifice in order to get that shorter version are some very strong action scenes and some quite kinetic stuff. But they were, in a way, making the film slightly relentless. So that's what's happened. And I'm hoping that, you know, those scenes that we cut out can in a way get a little kind of life of their own on, you know, virals or whatever, you know, that we can somehow find a way of releasing them.
That's my follow-up question.
Okay.
I do prefer the shorter version. But what now that Netflix is pushing into original films, and pushing into original films in a really big way, I'm wondering, have you even spoken to them about offering, for fans of the movie, having a button that makes you can play the extended cut, or having a button where you can play the deleted scenes, or has that not come up?
That has come up in conversation, and I believe that is, you know, the sort of, you know, behind the scenes type stuff that you get on a DVD extra.
Sure.
is something that people are talking about. I don't know how far down the line that is, but we have definitely talked about being able to, you know, take, for example, that waterfall sequence, or one of the battle sequences when they arrive back onto the mainland again, which we've removed as sort of standalone scenes, you know, that we can put out in some way on social media or in some form, and that would be kind of fun. It'd be great for me to take some of the stuff that is on the cutting room floor and let it have a life of its own, because we've got some great stuff. But I am very proud and feel the right decision was made with the existing cut of the movie.
Yeah, no, I definitely prefer the shorter cut. It moves faster. It just, yep. You know what I mean? But that's a sidebar. I heard from one of your actors that your first cut was like 4 hours. Is that true?
That's true, yeah. The first assembly, but assemblies are always long, so it's not a big deal. You know, but we shot a lot of great material. I mean, and for a film of this scale, you know, a 65-day shoot was not a long thing with all those action sequences. So, we were very productive during those 65
sure.
days, and we got some good stuff. But the point is that you want to make a playable experience for an audience. You want to get them to go through the story in a way which gives them the information they need, gives them the characters they need, gives them the energy they need, gives them the emotion they need, and is an enjoyable ride. And that's the journey we've gone on to try and get to where we are now.
One of the things I find fascinating about your process is you like to shoot with like 4 or 5 cameras. You sometimes have them hidden away, if you will, and you run these really long takes, like 15 minutes. When did that first start happening? When did you realize that that's the way you kind of like to shoot?
Well, actually, in a way, on this film, and I don't know whether I necessarily want to have that many cameras on this film because of all the other things that are going on, all the large amount of you know, the scope we were working on, it would seem crazy not to have multiple cameras shooting that stuff and taking advantage of it. I don't normally have that level of them, but I do like to run takes long because I think the actors kind of get into it and they feel the connection to what they're doing and the interaction with what they're doing in a much more real way. And the sort of idea of this movie was to make an epic realist movie, and so getting people into the spirit of what they're doing was part of it. So getting, you know, not all of those long takes are obviously in the film, but the bits that are and the bits either side of it are what allow the bits that are in the film to be alive and to feel real and to let the interaction and spontaneity sometimes of the moments come out.
You filmed in some very remote locations in Scotland. I think some that have never been used in movies before. Talk a little bit about trying to film in these locations, because I'm sure some of them were tough to get to.
They were hard. Logistically, it was hard to get to. In particular, we had two or three beach scenes on Sky and stuff. You know, in some fairly wild locations. One of the great things about those locations is they haven't really changed for 700 years. So you're kind of representing medieval life, kind of almost by default in these locations. They were tough to get to. But they were lovely, and they're probably among my favourite. The light and the elements really kind of came together, and we were blessed by good weather. You know, for example, we were in boats for 2 days, and the wind was in the right direction for 1 day, and then changed and was in the right direction for the next day. If it had gone the other way around, it would have been a real nightmare. So, being able to film in Scotland and a film about Scotland, and to use the landscape, which is so important to them as it is to us now. It was a real, real blessing.
I have to stop there. I'm going to say congratulations on the movie. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much for yours.